A selenophile is what you call a person who loves the moon, and understandably so. It is difficult not to be enchanted by the moon's calming light and how it casts a majestic glow against the night sky. But what if we had two of those? After seeing how having twin moons will affect the Earth, would you still love the moon as much? Sure, a two-mooned Earth has been a science fiction staple for decades, but with scientists plotting to turn this sci-fi fantasy into reality, it makes us wonder whether this is a good idea or not. How different would life on Earth be? And how can mankind survive the changes? Welcome to The Bestest, the channel that provides you the bestest news and videos you should know about. Put on your spacesuit and hop on, because today, we're taking you on an exploration to find out what would happen to the Earth if it had two moons. Make sure to stick around till the end of the video. We're telling you, each stage of change has its own set of surprises. Plus, we're sharing some of the most fascinating trivia about the giant nightlight. Before we start, please make sure to like and subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell for more mind-blowing videos. Ready to find out what a two-moon future holds? Luckily for us, physics professor Neil Commons already did a lot of the scientific work for us so that we won't have to leave everything to speculation or rely on sci-fi mumbo-jumbo. In his book, What If the Earth Had Two Moons?, Commons explains in full detail his science-based theories on what this amazing yet possibly apocalyptic scenario holds. One thing you have to understand first is that the moon is responsible for a lot of what makes the Earth a habitable planet. Our moon is unique in the solar system. While most of the other planets have moons that are about 10,000 times smaller, our moon is just about 1/81st the size of the Earth. Earth to moon ratio is what brought about the tides that stirred up life on Earth. It's the reason we have 24 hours a day, and why our planet is tilted on its axis just right. Now, if the universe brings in another moon into the picture, all these would change. Stage 1. Getting into orbit. Picture this. The moon's identical twin comes hurtling by, but because of the Earth's gravitational pull, it is trapped into orbit, sitting right between our planet and the moon. The moon and its twin, which we'll call Luna to avoid confusion, would both be visible from the Earth, and Luna would look about twice as big because it is closer to us. What a spectacular view that must be. And here's another visual treat for us humans: two moons, who would mean twice as many solar eclipses. Cool, right? It would also be likely that the moon and Luna will have different phases. So we're probably gonna have to rethink the way we measure months and adopt a mixture of short and long months. Liking what you're hearing so far? Honey, we're just at stage 1. Wait till you see what other surprises Luna has in store for us. But before that, time for a quick trivia. The moon's formation. According to scientists from NASA, our moon was formed some 4.5 billion years ago. It started when a celestial body that was about as big as Mars banged into our planet. The resulting debris started orbiting the Earth and eventually formed our current moon. Although its formation sounds like a remarkable event, we probably wouldn't want a repeat of this, because after it gets into orbit, this is what happens next. Stage 2. Wild tides. As Luna settles between us and the moon, its gravitational pull would amplify the original moon's effect on our planet's tides. It would yank violently at the oceans, causing tidal waves like nothing we've ever seen before. The differences between high and low tides would be thousands of feet apart, and enormous peak tides would be 6 to 8 times bigger than our current tides. A huge chunk of habitable land, including major cities like Singapore, London, New York, all of that, gone. If humans do survive these tides, we'd have to come up with new ways to use the ocean for transfer, travel, and maybe even for settlement, because seaside buildings would likely be constantly destroyed by these tides. And that's just the beginning. Stage 3. Doomsday. Because of the tug of war between the Earth and its moons, the tidal waves would cause earthquakes left and right. All this movement would also result in greater volcanic activities, opening up new volcanoes and stirring even those that have long been dormant. Because of the constant tidal waves, the earthquakes and volcanic activity could go on for years, so even if we survive stage 2, there's no telling if we can still live through this stage. And we're not just talking about mankind, even marine life could go extinct, which in turn would lead to catastrophic changes to our ecosystem. Scary, huh? Well, we're only halfway through, so you better stick around because the worst is not yet over. But let's take a quick break with another interesting trivia. Hitchhiker moons. The Earth is not as monogamous as you might think. According to some researchers, the Earth sometimes has its flings with other moon-like bodies. Yep, our planet has two or more companions at a time. Sometimes small asteroids wander around our solar system, get trapped into our orbit, makes several rounds over the course of a few weeks or months, until they decide to take off and leave Earth to its one true moon. Luckily, so far, none of these hitchhiking moons have been big enough to cause any ill effects to our planet. Back to our exploration. Stage 4. A hellish moon. The Earth is not the only one that undergo apocalyptic changes. Because of Luna's position, the Earth and the moon would be yanking at it back and forth from both directions. This would warp Luna's surface, causing tremendous volcanic activity and flooding it with rivers of lava. Kind of like Jupiter's moon, Io. This would turn Luna into a smooth, beautiful giant lamp in the sky. But it's unlikely mankind would survive long enough to witness this, along with some other changes. Stage 5. Longer days. You know how some people say there aren't enough hours in a day? That's one less thing to worry about in a two-mooned Earth. With the twin satellites illuminating the sky, there would only be fewer hours of real darkness. And then, there's the fact that as it is, the moon is already spiraling away from the Earth at about the speed the average human's fingernails grow. As it drifts slowly away, the moon tugs at the Earth and causes it to slow down its rotation. That means every 40,000 years, we get an extra 1 second to our Earth days. This doesn't sound much, but with Luna in the picture, this process would accelerate, and a few million years later, one Earth day will have extended to 28 hours or more. All these changes, the longer hours and the brighter nights, could give chance for existing life forms to evolve or even maybe for new ones to arise. But if you think this is where it all ends, you're wrong. We're at the final stage, and before we get there, here's one last trivia that's a true shocker. China's second moon. In October 10, 2018, Wu Changfeng from Chengdu Aerospace Science made an announcement that sounded like the kind of plot you hear from cartoon villains. According to this Chinese state-owned corporation, they have plans to launch an artificial moon into space by 2020. This second moon, which they call an illumination satellite, would use reflected sunlight and bathe the ground in a dust-like glow that should help reduce the need for streetlights. Sounds like an admirable goal, but frankly, we're undecided about whether this is a good plan, especially after learning about the final stage that a two-mooned Earth would undergo. And the last stage, Stage 6, the lunar collision. Remember when we said the moon is slowly drifting away from the Earth? While the extra hours may sound like a treat, the problem is that the moon would also be pulling Luna towards it. After millions of years, these two satellites would inevitably collide. The impact would be so massive that the Earth would be victim to meteorite showers of epic proportions. Debris will go hurtling in all directions, forming massive craters that could mean the end of all life on Earth. The remaining debris that didn't enter the planet's atmosphere would likely get trapped in its gravitational pull. This would form a ring of debris orbiting around its equator, kind of like Saturn's rings. A few more years later, these debris are bound to clump together and give birth to a new moon that'll accompany the planet. Looks like, in the end, the Earth is still destined to have one moon by its side. Alright, after hearing all of these, what do you think about mankind trying to create a second moon? Let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to The Bestest and make sure to hit the bell to access more awesome videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until our next Bestest video.